Let's Hunt is a video series with tactics, weapons, locations, and other useful tips, always around one particular animal. Good to see you, Hunter, and welcome back to another Let's Hunt. This time we're going after European rabbits. You can find Euro rabbits here in Bush Rangers Run as well as in Val de Bois. Let's have a look at the maps. Thanks for these maps to community member Wayora. He's very likely the most successful player in Euro rabbit competitions. On the left side you can see Bush Rangers Run, and as you see you will find burrows all over the place where there is sandy desert. And on the right we have Val de Bois with the burrows in many places, but we have some concentration in the west, in the center, and then also north of the large Chalet du Mont Bleu. There is very little equipment that you really need. All I will bring here is the single shot shotgun, which every player can pick up for free. And if you own a tripod stand, a huge piece of equipment, you can bring that here as well. It can be useful here in this particular reserve. It takes up a lot of space in your inventory, but since you don't need much else, you can nicely stow this away. I'm starting here at the Copper Hills Lodge. It's the Western Lodge, the one that leads us into the desert. This desert is full of rabbits as well as red foxes. Red fox is rather easy to hunt here. It's the only animal calling here. You will not have any feral hawks or red kangaroos coming over here. So if you're after red foxes, this is a great place. Starting time doesn't really matter at all. And also my camouflage is zero. It doesn't matter what you wear, as you will see. It's all about the tactics. What I will do now is I will simply run around and look for burrows or tracks from the rabbits. Here we have a first track. You can see I've been roughly running for about 12 minutes. And we have some Euro rabbits. They are 1 hour old, at least this one. This one says 1 to 7 minutes, so it's very close, which means it'll lead me to the burrows. So this is the rabbit that I just picked up. Still roaming. So what you want to look for is a fleeing track. If you cannot find the burrow, I found it already, that's nice. But in general, if you are looking for a burrow, in most cases you will find tracks first, and you want to follow recent fleeing tracks. They will lead you to the burrow, because what the rabbits will do is they will rush into the holes and hide from you. So one thing I always do here is I will click around and put a lot of X's on my hunter mate. You can see the X's pile up there, because I want to know how many rabbits we're dealing with. These are all known rabbits right now. I think I have 4 different ones. More holes. Oh, there's one coming. And my shotgun's not loaded. Anyway, so rabbits are running into the holes. When you get there, do better than I just did. Be prepared. Usually they run into the same hole. Maybe there's more coming, but it doesn't matter much because they will come back out. Listen. Oh, there's one coming out already. And the first rabbit goes down before we can even explain how this works. So, point number one, find the holes. Point number two, Look for all the tracks so you have an idea how many rabbits there are. There's a new one here. And then point number three, check out where all the holes are. So we have a few of them here. You can see there's quite a few here. Then we have them all here. And the next point is you want to find a high place where you can oversee all the holes. It doesn't have to be, you don't have to run far away and hide somewhere. All you need to do is stand here and wait. And the rabbits will come out one by one. It might take a few minutes in between, but they will come out. Now this is something that I only realized after some time, after making some videos. People said to me, how can you turn around so fast? There's the next. Came out right here in front of me. They're not scared. The game will push them out of the holes whether they want or not. So people ask me, how can you turn around so fast? And I have to tell you, this is really important also, at least for me. I have set the mouse movement speed under Windows to max, and also in the game, so I can turn around really quickly. And I think this is important for the rabbit hunting, because what I also will do many times is I will actually aim at the holes and just listen. And now let's see if I can show you how fast I can turn around, because this is important. So I'm looking at the rabbit here. And what's really keeping me from turning all the way is my mouse cable. You can see I can turn around really fast and turn towards the sound. Wherever I hear the rabbit, I will turn towards, and I have enough time to shoot it. There's the next, right here. Three rabbits down already. I just got here really, but as you can see, they will come out, and if you're fast enough, you can shoot them. The three rabbits that have come out so far were not scared, but many times they will come out and disappear right away, and this is why you need to be ready with the shotgun. There's the next. And I've really been talking and talking, and I don't think you've actually heard the rabbits come out. So this time I'll stay quiet. All I will do is aim at the burrows, at the holes, and listen for... rabbits to come out. Five rabbits. What you can do now is, I think we have shot a few of them already, a lot of them already. So I don't actually know if there's any rabbits left. Now let's see if there's any tracks left. If there are no tracks left, you can move on. You have shot all the rabbits. I think that's the case already, actually. So I don't see any other tracks. What I can do is just stick around to make sure. However, I believe this is it. This is why it is important to run around the burrow and just pick up all the tracks, so you can actually be sure that you have shot them all. No X's on the hunter mate. So in this particular burrow there were only 5 rabbits. You can have, I want to say, up to 10 rabbits. It's rare, but it can happen. So this burrow we emptied without the tripod stand, just standing here in the middle. But I have to admit, it was an easy place. The holes right around me here, very easy to see. Sometimes the holes will be in one of these green bushes, so you don't see it at all. You don't even see the rabbits coming out. This one was easy. What you can also do is stand on top of a rock in the middle of the holes just to get a little bit of elevation. So in the next burrow that we find, we will use the tripod stand so I can show you how this is really helpful. So let me keep running. I will look for the next burrow. And here we have the next rabbit track. 1 hour old. You can't really do much with these 1 hour old tracks. So I will look for more recent tracks, but you can see there's a lot of them here. So hopefully one of them will be younger. This one's good. Now, of course, you can also just run and search, but this can be really hard. Oh, now this one is recent. Just looking for the burrow is really hard. You want to go by the tracks. Rabbit went over here somewhere. The X's on the hunter mate can also be an indication where the holes will be. And we have no more tracks here, we have to go back. Let's go look on this side. Make sure the shotgun's ready and loaded. So it looks like they have to be back there somewhere. Although there's no more tracks here. Sometimes it's just one or two holes. And you really have to find that particular one. Going in the distance can also help, because the vegetation will disappear. Thank you. And I still haven't found it. This one's recent. Looking for a fleeing track, really. Where the heck did you go? So these are recent tracks. But I have yet to find a fleeing one. This is a fox. Can be that the hole or the holes are somewhere underneath these bushes, or they can be so flat on the ground that you don't see them either. And this one's really interesting. There's no big rabbit among the tracks that I've seen so far, so I might as well just abandon it. But I would actually like to find it. Sometimes you can see the rabbits in the distance. Telling you where they are. So you can see there's little vegetation when I look like this. And once I start glassing, everything returns. I can see a rabbit. Just a red fox laughing at me from the distance. So I will stick to this one. This one is a recent track. There's a number of them here from this rabbit. He must have a fleeing track at some point. You can see on the map they can spread out quite far. And when danger comes, they will run to the holds. Just where are they? Oh, finally. So here we go. We have a lot of rabbits here. That's for sure. And now we're checking out the holds. We have them here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, there's more up here. At least 7 visible holds. So this time I will use the tripod stand, put it right in the middle. And get the shotgun ready. Oh, now I cannot see one of the holds here. And I think that's where the first rabbit just came out. So let me move this. Did I get this one? I think I got it. There's another one coming out already. Oftentimes what you will see is you move around, you run around, you put up equipment. And once you're quiet, they pop out as if they were waiting to come out. There's the next. I find the single shot a really great weapon for this. It has a good range and it barely ever lets me down. Three rabbits down. Looks like we have all the holds in view. And again, you really have to be able to turn quickly. There's the next. There's so many. So right now they will keep coming. going to collect these. Sometimes they will be within the burrow, within the earth here, and you cannot collect them until you actually go down. This one is easy. Or we might have another one that we cannot really pick up. This one is also possible. But then what you will have to do is just go down and within the hole like this, and then you can see it and pick it up. So looking at the map, the X's disappear, and actually we might be done already. The one X left could be a fox. So let's check this track. What is it actually? It's a fox. So all the X's are gone. We have emptied this burrow as well. This is how you can use the tripod stand. If you wouldn't have one, see, here's a rock. Now you can see these holes. Let me get rid of this quickly. But here's another one, which would have worked just as well. You can see this hole, the two up here, the two over here, and the two over here. So you have all holes in view from this rock. In most cases, you will find an elevated spot. So you can do this, or you can use the tripod. So much for bush rangers. We've had two burrows, no more rabbits left. Looking for the burrow can be hard sometimes. You have to run around quite a bit. Just keep following the tracks. Enough talking for the Australian map. Let's fly over to Europe. And here we are in Val de Bois in the European map. I'm over here in the west. And I actually just fast traveled here to my tent, and if you listen, you can hear rabbits. I'm in the middle of them already. This is a good place. Again, I will use my shotgun, and here on this map, instead of the tripod, I will use the tree stand, and we will do the same. We will look for a burrow. Try without and with the tree stand, just to show you the difference, and this might also help you to decide whether or not you want to buy a tree stand just for rabbit hunting. Like said, I can hear them already. They will be super surprised if I show up here now. Oh, look at this. Oh, look at this. Oops, wrong weapon. So he is fleeing. And let's see where he's fleeing. And again, be ready. Oh, here's the hole already. There might now be rabbits running in. Elevated spot. Oh, down there is more holes. We might have rabbits running in. Given the tracks, there is a few here. Oh, there's one. There you are. So let's try and collect this just like that. Now you can see it, you cannot collect it. Thanks for this beautiful example. Crawl into the hole, and when you see the rabbit, you can pick it up. So again, with and with without the stand, looking where the holes are, I can see these four. One is up there. Since everything went so fast, I don't know how many rabbits we have here. What's a bit annoying when aiming is the breathing. So I'm quitting the aim mode just because of that. Activity right now. I think at least one more rabbit should be around. The one that ran into the hole when I pulled out the crossbow instead of the shotgun. That's not the one that ran in afterwards. Could be that there is more holes and I'm just not seeing them up here, maybe. No, this is really it. So I'm not getting any more rabbits here. This can happen, that rabbits go away from the burrow and don't find their way back, at least not in the time when you are around. Even though we have some tracks here, we simply don't get any more rabbits out of the holes. If you wait for a while and you don't have any new rabbits coming out, then just leave. Unless there is really a fat one sitting in there somewhere. But otherwise it's not worth it. You can wait for a long time and you might never see any rabbits anymore around that burrow. Like with any other animal, of course, make sure to read all the tracks. Level up your tracking skill. This is important, especially for rabbits, since they are scored by their weight. The heaviest rabbit is 2.5 kilograms, and any rabbit you find over 2.4 kilograms is really a potential competition winner. Once you are at level 20 with your tracking skill, you only want to go after rabbits that say 2.2 to 2.5 kilograms, so it has to be over 2.2. You can follow a 2.1 to 2.5, in that range you can follow it, but it's not likely gonna be a very heavy rabbit. So I will continue running down this west side of Val de Bois looking for the next burrow. Here we go, just finding this track here, over 60 minutes old. This one as well. So this tells us somewhere we have a new burrow. I can hear a rabbit running. Oh, poor guy. Okay. So I think he's showing us where the burrow is. He was trying to run over here. And he gave away the place where he lives. At least that's what I'm hoping. Here the tracks are more recent. And here we have the holes. Get the shotgun out, be ready. So this is now a place that is not ideal for standing around, it looks. This guy just came out of this hole, so there's one more hole here. See, this hole is almost, well, it's almost level to the ground, not easy to find. Maybe there's more over here. So I was hoping I could show you the tree stand version, but this is not ideal. The trees are too far away. So let's do the standing on rocks version. It's European rabbit hunting on the rocks. How about that? That's a lightweight. So this place is not ideal. Not standing in a good place. I'm not sure if wind plays a role. Right now I'm upwind. Actually I'm downwind if the wind goes north. So this might be an advantage. Rabbits are coming out. I just heard another that went right back in. So here, this is a bit awkward. I don't know where to stand. If I stand up here, I don't see all the holes, but I'm downwind of the rabbits. But then what I find is many times they will come out of the same few holes, even though there's many. I can hear one, don't know where it is. So in bush rangers, the problem is the holes can be under bushes, and here the problem is they can be somewhere hidden in the forest. So always you will have to find a good spot. Oftentimes it's easy, this one in particular is not easy. So they seem to come out of this hole mostly. We had one over here too. We have a few tracks left. This one is old. This one is not too old. Let's look at this one down here. Like I said, sometimes the rabbits run away and never really find their way home. This one's young though. So I think that rabbit is still here. And so is this one. I believe we have at least two rabbits left here. And the place to oversee everything just doesn't exist here. Plus there's no tree close enough for the tree stand. One just came out, maybe down here. But there's no track. I keep hearing a rabbit come out, and I don't know where it is. Many times it lays a track when it comes out, but there's no tracks around these holes. We'll try this place once more. I think it's important to have headphones also with the speakers. You might not be able to tell exactly the direction where you hear the rabbit. And now I can hear something. It's not a rabbit, it's a brown bear. I can hear a brown bear breathe down there somewhere. Since the introduction of the grizzly bear, we can hear bears breathe. They also changed the brown bear that lives here. They changed the black bear. So standing here will not give me any rabbits. We'll try this one once more. And since there is no large rabbit Either we can get it or we can't, and then we'll just move on. There you go, what took you so long? Alright, once again, I'm really not sure about the wind. It could make sense that, you know, your smell goes into the holes and they can smell you. It would make sense. So I'm standing north, wind is going this way, and I'm out of the wind here. I had a few times where I thought this might actually be an advantage if you're downwind. It doesn't hurt. If you have trouble with the rabbits coming out, just go downwind and see if that makes a difference. It's just a tip. I have no facts to prove that this actually works. I just noticed a few times, like here, as soon as I'm downwind, rabbits come out. Rabbit running north, 1 hour old. What am I spotting? European rabbit? I'm spotting a rabbit. Hello? Oh, look! Hello! How are you? This I've seen in the past as well. I actually made a video just with a rabbit like this. Well, this is so cool. Thanks for coming and for showing yourself here. This is funny. These are rabbits that are just stuck like that. They don't spook. You cannot push them away. Ugh. They will just stand there and be happy. Well, thanks for showing yourself. This is great. And actually, you may live because you were so nice and you're not fat as well. This is interesting. Sometimes you will find stuck rabbits like this. And, well, I'm not sure if you are the track here. Is this you? Is this your track there? Nice. Well, anyway, I will keep going. Good meeting you, and maybe another time. Here's another rabbit, so we might be near a burrow. They're all pointing north. Oh, there you go. And now the question is, do we have recent tracks? This is important because this is all old stuff here. Oh, let's just stand on the rock here quickly. Get the shotgun ready just in case. No one's returning home. Well, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 holes. There's more holes than rabbits, really. Is this one recent? Yes, so we have a rabbit at least sitting in this hole. And one of these holes, it doesn't matter. Here is another recent track. So we do have at least two guys around, maybe more. I can hear one. Just came out and went back in. How about a tree stand here? Nope. there's no tree around. Ideally, we would have a tree about here. And rabbits are coming out left and right. This one is not in a hurry at all. So again, this is a place to just stand on a rock and wait. This is super ideal. Can't get any better than this. You're standing in the middle and rabbits will be around you. Well, actually less holes would be more ideal. But as far as the rock location, you can oversee all 9 holes from here. This is not the case many times. So I'm thinking 2 to 3 rabbits should be here. I'm sure that it's 2, I'm not sure if it's 3. There they come. And I missed. I was just gonna say, sometimes it helps running around, getting back on the rock. Now if you look, 27 meters with a single shot, shotgun not a problem. It's really good for this. Excellent, we're getting the rabbits. Let's collect them. Just leveled up the weapon. Unfortunately, the only thing that changes when leveling up your weapon is only that there's less wobble, which doesn't really matter at all with a shotgun. I wish there was less breathing. So let's look at the tracks. What have we removed? This track here was recent. This means there is at least one more rabbit. Gives us enough time, and it's the one. You can see it's highlighted. It's our rabbit that we just talked about. I think this track will now disappear. Yes, it does, which means we might be out of rabbits here. If you're not sure, again, check the tracks. If all you have is 1 hour old tracks, don't even bother. You will never see these rabbits again. Or you see them up there sitting under a tree enjoying the sun. So I'm not sure if rabbits get lost and then just give up and say, oh well, I cannot find home, you might as well shoot me. So I'm gonna restart and I will not show you another footage until I found a burrow with an ideal place for a tree stand. And here we are at the Northern Lodge of Val de Bois, the Chalet du Mont Bleu. And this time, just for fun and just for a change, I will bring different weapons. I will bring an over and under shotgun. I'll bring the air rifle as well as the grasshopper pistol. And not to forget the tree stand, so I can finally show you how you can also utilize that for shooting the European rabbits. And we found a burrow right away up here, north of the lodge. There's a bunch of trees here. As usual, just look if there's any rabbits running in. Wow, there's a lot of holes. So this tree over here looks about right. Gonna mount it on the outside here. So that this tree is not too much in the way. And here we are. I don't think this is ideal. Maybe we'll change position later. And the roe deer agrees with me. This is not perfect. The rabbits don't like it either, so let's change. Oh, there's a better tree here. It's quite a distance though for the shotgun. Very high up. So this is clearly a distance for the air rifle. This is unzoomed. And then you can zoom all the way in. With the air rifle though, you will hit rabbits and they can continue to run. So it's not perfect. And we missed one already. But at least they're coming out. So this one I probably hit as well, just not good enough, but at least we have one. Let's try the grasshopper then. Just missed one. Apart from the shotgun, this pistol and the air rifle, of course, you also have the Plinkenton rifle, which also shoots these pellets. And with that, you can do really long shots, and every hit will be pretty much a kill. So for this particular burrow, I could also stand on this rock here with the shotgun and just listen and shoot at everything that moves. I would have thought with this tree stand that the rabbits would be less scary. I have a quite some distance here anyway. But they're still pretty skittish. And at some point the breathing really gets annoying. Alright, where's the next rabbit? There it is. Just disappearing as well. So I'm not sure if this location is not good. We'll try. The rock over there then. So the point of the tree stand really is that you can overlook all the burrows. That's really the idea of it. But in this case it's too far away, but I think you get the point how you can utilize that. In this case I would really just sit here and listen for anything that moves. Wonder if this is blood. So this was the air rifle shot, which I was pretty sure I had hit it. But many times with the air rifle, animals will survive. This also happens with the ducks. So I'll do one more attempt here if I can find it with the shotgun. These guys are really persistent. So maybe one last advice. If they're not coming out, just try different positions. No, this was the tree stand direction. That didn't work. Try different positions. Stick around. Just wait a bit. If they never come, you have to change position. As you've seen before also. For some reason, here they come. And they wouldn't come from up in the tree stand. So this has been going well ever since we've been over here. Alright. So there's a few tracks left, but I think you get the point. Stick around the holes, try good to find a good position. Bring a stand, a tree stand, or a tripod stand. The tripod would, by the way, also work here. And then just wait for them to come out. There's another one. Alright, so enough rabbits killed for today. I hope this helped for finding these little buggers. They're quite fun. The challenge is to find them, but once you have the burrow, just sit tight and wait. They will come out. Thanks a lot for watching, and we'll be in touch. I hope you enjoyed Never Got Annoyed. Thank you very much. Stay in touch.